The Life of Laurent. Laurent was a nomadic vampire and member of James' coven. Following James' encounter with the Olympic coven, he became a member of the vegetarian Denali coven, which included his mate Irina, though he often disregarded their dietary guidelines and admitted to cheating. He was killed by the shapeshifters of the Uley pack after an attempt to kill Bella Swan. His life and death counterpart is Lauren. Welcome to the Amagi. In today's video, we're going over the life of Laurent. Before we begin, we publish a new video every day, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. Early life. Laurent was born in the early 1700s in Paris, France, into an aristocratic but financially embarrassed family during the reign of King Louis XIV. He was the third son and had little in the way of prospects. Laurent was recommended for a minor position in the court of the Sun King by his older brother, who married into a more prosperous family. Laurent loved being a part of the court and had ambitions to rise. He was always attracted to people with power and curried their favor. He had a knack for discerning who the most important person was in any given grouping and then attaching himself to that person. There was a certain way about Laurent that made anyone he singled out feel more important. Therefore, he did well among the other aristocrats and had a promising future. His life changed when a mysterious ambassador named Boris, purportedly from the Romanov court in Russia, made a diplomatic visit to the French court. The ambassador's strange behavior was attributed to cultural differences. He came out of his quarters only at night, kept a retinue of mute servants and soldiers who were totally obedient, and always put off discussions of matters of state. He did seem to enjoy the entertainments of the French court immensely and was very interested in King Louis's art collection. Laurent was drawn to the powerful Boris and befriended him. When the mysterious disappearances of men and women began to attract notice, the ambassador had to move on. Before he did, he offered Laurent the opportunity to go with him, which he accepted out of his thirst for power. Eventually, Boris told him the truth about himself, and Laurent begged him to share his power and immortality, and he complied. Boris became his companion for a while, until Laurent grew tired of his creator's jovial habits and left him to find someone with more power. He ran into one of the surviving Romanians, Vladimir, who still radiated some of the power he once held. However, he did not stay for long, as he next turned to the Volturi, who held the exact kind of power that he sought. However, Arrow turned him away after finding out that he had encountered the Romanians and declared him as untrustworthy. He continued to hope that he would get another chance to join the Volturi, though the chance was never offered. He wandered the world, allying with anyone who seemed to have power, until he found someone more powerful. Eventually, he joined James' coven. The three of them once tracked down a werewolf across Siberia. They then went to the U.S., becoming nomads. Twilight. Laurent, James, and Victoria came across the Cullen family playing baseball while passing through Forks. When James and Victoria chose to hunt Bella Swan, his instincts told him he was on the wrong side of the conflict, and he quickly jumped ship to ingratiate himself with the Cullens by warning them about James' skills. Laurent was confused by Carlyle, who had a very different kind of authority than he was used to. He was happy to stay out of the way until James was no longer an issue, hoping to study Carlyle's strength later. He left for Denali to find the Denali coven, hoping to get away from James and Victoria. During his time with them, he became the mate of Irina and found Tanya's influence similar to Carlyle's. He allowed their peaceful life to envelop, though he found animal blood revolting and fed on humans from time to time, thus keeping the red-eyed color that human-feeding vampires display. When Victoria sought him out, and after he was sure he was not there to kill, he was seduced anew by the old kind of command. He also told her about the Cullen's powers. He decided to keep the lines of communication open with her and do her one favor she asked of him, to spy on Bella and the Cullens. Midnight Sun. Laurent left for Denali to escape Victoria and James. Edward considered killing him in a fit of rage, but restrained himself to focus on Bella's safety. New Moon. Laurent returned as a scout for the vengeful Victoria and found out that the Cullens were no longer living in Forks. When Bella visited Edward's meadow, Laurent stumbled across her while hunting. He found Bella's scent irresistible and decided to kill her himself. However, Laurent was chased off by the sudden appearance of a pack of werewolves before he could strike. Laurent mistakenly recognized the shapeshifters as werewolves. This mistake may have occurred because he had accompanied James on a hunt for a werewolf across Siberia years beforehand. He exclaimed, "I don't believe it," as he was shocked to see them in their wolf form in broad daylight with no full moon to generate the phasing, and working together. True werewolves do not run in packs. Bella, having no idea what the strange creatures were, aside from huge wolves, fled in terror after the wolves chased Laurent out of the clearing. Later, after Bella found out about Jacob being a shapeshifter, he told her that they had killed Laurent and that they have chased Victoria away frequently, though she kept coming back. Physical appearance. In the novels, Laurent is described as 5 feet 9 inches tall, with glossy black hair, a slight olive tone to his pale skin, and a French accent. He had a medium, slightly muscular frame and an easy smile. As with all vampires, his skin sparkled upon exposure to sunlight as if thousands of diamonds were embedded in his skin, and had dark red eyes that turned black when he was thirsty. In the films, Laurent was portrayed quite differently to his description in the books, being dark-skinned, and had dreadlocks that ran down to his shoulders and mustache. He also showed a muscular torso through his open jacket and walked barefoot. Personality and traits. Unlike his coven mates, James and Victoria, Laurent was articulate and civilized. Bella Swan considered him to be easily the most attractive of James' coven. He had little sense of loyalty as he betrayed James' plans, his coven leader, to the Cullens, disregarded the Denali coven's vegetarian diet, and tried to painlessly kill Bella against Victoria and the Cullens' wishes. In the Twilight Saga, the official illustrated guide, Laurent was described as an ambitious man who was drawn to those with power, to ally himself with them until they were decimated, and then he would flee for his life. Did you enjoy the video? Be sure to tell us in the comments. And make sure to subscribe. And check out these other great videos from the Amagi. If you'd like to support me, you can also subscribe to my personal channel. See you guys tomorrow!